Back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to see about SQLite. SQLite is a database management program. So right here, I have what done is imported the SQLite and connected with the database. So if you see in the directory, there is no database even in this folder. So now if I run it, you will see the magic. The database is created. So this is used to connect the database and create. So I will create an cursor is used to connect with the database. Just communicates to execute the program, and this is used for executing. Means we will give the connection command that create an table called one, and what one will have. And these are the two data types that we are seeing today: integer and text. Integer means the numbers, and text means the normal text. So I will try id will be integer, and then name text, and then let's take email as a text, let's take as age, let us make it integer, right? So now if we create the database, so it has the table inside it. We see now the table is created. So we will also see how to view data. View data, this is the query, select all. Starting means the all, select all from table 1, right? And it will not give us the data like that. What we need to do is use cursor.fetchAll. We have to call this function. In this function, the data is stored. Now if we see the data, it will just show empty square brackets, means there is no data. So for that you need to insert the data. I will add here one more query just after it, and the query is insert into one. And what things we have to insert in it was id, and then it was name, email, and then it was age. So if we count these are 4, and type here values. Values means what we have to add. Means here will come id as the sequence. So there are the 4. I will add question mark 4 times. Okay. So there I add the question mark 4 times. So you will say that these are not the values. So what the question mark does, it just helps to provide the values. So I will have plaster and tuple right here of two brackets, right? And here will the values come, right? The first one will be 1, id is 1, right? And after that we see after id the name comes, so I will just name it John. And after that the email is there, just name it john@example.com. Anything take, and age, I will take the ages, let's take 15. Okay, so now if I run it, what will happen? Let's see. It shows the data right here because of this query. It select all from one, and we have fetched it, right? So the database, in the database that is added, we'll add one more, that will be 2, and let's name it Kelly, and email also something like that, and let us change the age to something like 20. Now if we see, Kelly is also added. So in real, if we just comment it out, so then you will say that yep, now if I comment it out and say, you see nothing, and that's fine, because we need to commit the connection. And you will ask, what is committing? So let me tell you, committing means saving the all work we have done, and it's in good practice closing the connection, means it will not lag a lot if it has a lots of records. Let me make this one. And let me just add 2, just replace it with the John and so add. So now you can see that there are both of these. Means the connection has saved. And if I remove it, I want to show you some types. Now if you see that there is all. But in the data, there are three types of fetch. One is fetch all and the second is fetch one. What the fetch one does is fetch the starting one. If you see right here, it has just fetched starting one. And there is the last one, fetch many. Fetch many, if I type here two, it fetches all. If I type here one, it will fetch only one. Means it just takes the order wise. Means how much columns you want to take. Like the first column is that, and the second column means we have to take two columns. It understands. If there was one more, then it will be only two, and three it will show three. And if I type anything, it will just show the first one. So let me just keep it on one or two. Okay. So this was for the today's tutorial. So you can see this working all nice. And this was for the today's tutorial. So what we have learned, let us revise it. We have just learned to fetch all data from the table and fetch one, fetch many, and like so many. Okay, so thanks for watching. Bye.